So EXA and their sister brand One Audio have been releasing some really amazing headphones that have almost changed the game on entry level, because these headphones really punch way above their weight class. But today we are going to check out their E400, which is their latest release, which is the cheapest one for me, coming at $30 or 2000 rupees in India. And if they are going to keep it at this price point, it is going to be really weird, because they seem to have competing products in the same price range that are better. Hey guys, I am Siddharth, and let's talk about all of that. Inside the box, you get the headphones wrapped inside bubble wrap. You get a cardioid microphone, which is very interesting. We have a splitter for the combined mic and headphone jack, and we have some manuals along with this. The build and design of this headphone is decent in this price range. It is made completely of plastic, but it doesn't feel cheap in quality, and they have really tried to make this look and feel as good as possible with the limited selection of materials we have for this headset. The headset terminates in a 3.5mm connector, which you can split with the included adapter, and there is also a USB connector here, which is just for powering the RGB lights on this headphone. I have to say that this is the purest implementation of RGB that I have ever seen in a headphone, because it actually only has fixed color R, G and B LEDs on it, and they just light up when you plug in the USB port in, and there is no animation or changing of colors here. This is of course not an issue at this price range, but I just had to point this out because many of you may get confused about this when you see this in images online, and you may think that you would be able to set this to any color like an ARGB headphone. The cable for the E400 does have volume control and a microphone mute slider, which is nice. Moving on, the headband cushion is just a rubber covering on the inside, so there is no padding here, but the headphone is so light that you don't really need it. The headband adjustment mechanism works fine, but then we reach to the biggest issue with this headphone, which is the lack of any kind of adjustment for the ear cups. So in addition to not having any swivel, they also don't have any tilt adjustment, so when you put them on your head, the ear pads are going to be at a really uncomfortable angle. The size of the ear pads is actually not that bad in this range, but the lack of any adjustment just makes them too uncomfortable on my head to recommend. The lower section of the ear pads just digs into your ears, because for the ear cups to be at a proper angle, you would need to have a head that is this wide. The ear pads do have good enough padding and they are removable, which is great to see, but without a properly designed headband, the comfort is really bad with these headphones. If you are buying this for a kid or a teenager, it might fit them, but for most adult-sized heads, I really don't think that this is going to be comfortable. This is what the microphone on the XI400 sounds like, and it is actually pretty great. It is a cardioid mic, which means that it will pick up your voice from the direction of your mouth and it will reject the noise at its sides. I also tested the directionality and pickup pattern of this mic, and it is a legit cardioid mic, so that is kind of surprising to see in this price range. Do give this video a thumbs up if you've been enjoying it so far, and you can also subscribe with bell so you don't miss out on future videos. Coming to their sound quality, it is not bad in isolation for this price range, but they have themselves set the bar too high in this segment, so their E900 and One Audio A71 headphones are really on another level, and they sound much better than this E400. The sound on it feels muffled in comparison, it sounds distant, and overall they just don't have the dynamics in their sound that their own headphones in similar price range have. The ear cups also sit in a very weird angle on your head, so that also affects their sound quality. For gaming, these will still be fine, but just because you can hear gunshots in a headphone doesn't mean that it is also delivering great sound quality. So in conclusion, this is really the first headphone from EXA and One Audio that has been disappointing for me. This is a new headphone, so maybe that is why it is priced like this. But as of typing this review, the E400 is actually more expensive than the E900 on EXA's international website, and on Indian website, the E900 is only 100 rupees more expensive. The E900 is a headphone that is in a completely different galaxy from this E400. Even though I have their E900 Pro, the difference between the Pro and the non-Pro model is that the non-Pro model doesn't have memory foam ear pads, removable cable, and USB connectivity. But I think they have the same drivers inside, so the regular E900 would be a much better option than this, considering their price point is so close. If they reduce the price of E400 by half, then it could become a considerable option, but it is really almost unwearable for me, so rather than wasting even your $15, I would just go with the $30 E900 and get something that would actually actually be usable. Overall, I have to say that the One Audio A71 is the best value gaming headset that I have tried. The Exa E900 Pro offers better comfort than the A71, so that is also a good consideration. These are slightly more expensive than the regular E900, but they are definitely worth it. And the E900 should also be an excellent choice if you can't extend your budget. If you are in India, you can also go for the Claw SM50, which is basically a One Audio A71 but without a dedicated mic and some accessories. And I would highly recommend that you watch my 4 headphone comparison to decide which would be the best alternative for you in the same price range as the E400. Exa could have fixed the issue with this headphone easily. All they had to do was make the ear cups tiltable so the ear pads would sit parallel to your ears, and I would have very happily accepted the sacrifice of fixed RGB lighting on this to keep the cost the same. But maybe people really want to have RGB, so they decided to release an RGB product at low price. The mic on it is pretty good, but that isn't going to make up for its shortcomings in other areas. So I'll have links to buy all of these headphones I mentioned in the video description. Do give this video a thumbs up if you found it to be helpful, and feel free to let me know your thoughts about this in the comment section. Subscribe with bell, check out my Amazon store, follow me on socials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.